Lucetto Foods started in 1981. A gentleman came over from Switzerland, actually, settled in Fresno, and his idea at the time was to create products made like they were made in northern Italy or Switzerland. Today we're a facility producing over 360,000 pounds of salami a week. In 1991, when I came, we had 15 employees. Today we have 175. When all of us think of what the Valley produces, it's a pretty impressive group of products. But when you come to the expo and you physically see it, it really brings it home. And we're just very, very proud to be a part of it.
There's two families that own Certified Meat Products, my family as well as my partner's family. And so we have three generations now that have roots. We actually go back all the way back to the 50s, and one of our first customers was actually the McDonald's hamburger chain. For people here in the Valley to really recognize our product, a lot of the restaurants that they eat at every day are using our product, whether it be a hamburger chain or a steakhouse or whatever. If it's protein, it very well could be coming from us. We love our region. We are excited to be a major company here. We're not going anywhere. We love to service foods, and so for this, the Fresno Food Expo just kind of gives you that pride of being part of something bigger than yourselves. You get to see the big picture. It's the fifth time that we've been involved. We're one of the founding partners of the Fresno Food Expo, and just excited to be here. Again, another opportunity for us to just put a spotlight on what we're doing. And today we're producing a slider, and we're using Max's bread, which is displayed right over there. We're using a barbecue sauce made from Pappy's, which is displayed right here. So we do like to co-brand. Our distribution company wants to buy from local source. In fact, if you look on a nationwide basis and you ask the chefs around the nation, the number one trend is locally sourced meats, locally sourced produce. And so it's all about being able to do that. We're the food capital of the world, that we provide enough food coming from the San Joaquin Valley to feed one third of the world's population. And that's a pretty big statement. We kind of take our food for granted. We take the fresh produce we have, all of the fresh products that we have here for granted because we don't know any better. But I just have a core belief that if people got to know us, they'd like us.
It's 100% organic product, and it's also 100% estate grown. What that means is that every olive that goes in every bottle is grown by my family in Madeira. I'm actually the miller, so we mill it ourselves on our ranch in Madeira, and then we bottle it. This year we released a line of our infused olive oils, where we've actually taken organic Meyer lemons, organic garlic, organic basil, and infused them in with our extra virgin organic olive oil. I work side by side with my father, managing our three brands of PR Farms, Enzo Olive Oil, and Bella Fruta. And this has been our home for over 90 years. And to be able to make this place a better place and showcase the products that are grown here in the Valley to the rest of the world, it means something to us. It helps us tell the story of past and the present and also the future.
In business since 1938, we're the largest grower of peaches, plums, and nectarines in the United States. You know, the future looks bright. I mean, Ray Growen is the one that started the company. He still works every day. He's a farmer at heart. I mean, he's an industry icon, you know, because he's really developed, you know, the peach and you know, the Stoneford industry into what it is today. And his sons, Dan and Mike, are actively involved in the company. One of the unique things about our company is all the fruit that is packed in our boxes comes from land we own and trees and vines we've planted ourselves. We pride ourselves in quality and consistency with the ultimate goal in providing the consumer with a great eating experience.
We started in 1969. I walked into a back of a store that had a scaled down corn oven and it was up for sale, and I decided I would take a chance and buy this oven and make corn tortillas for a living. Everyone wants a tortilla on their plate. We're in all the major chains in the state of California, and we pretty much touch every state on the Pacific Rim now. I mean, on the Pacific, Oregon, Washington. We go into Arizona, Nevada, into the Midwest, and of course, we export also. Well, we have many, many opportunities. First thing I told myself many, many years ago is that there's a whole world out there. And so we have great opportunity. I see us evolving with our tortillas or tortilla chips. Our tortilla chips, because they travel so well, we have a great opportunity there. But it's a matter of seeking out opportunity and being in the right place when it does happen.
Nichols Farms is a third generation family owned and operated business. We started our processing facility in the 1980s. and currently we have about 2,200 acres of pistachios.
As you can tell, they're sorting again for the size of the kernel, the amount of insect damage, the color, and the overall appearance of it as well.
We're able to process anywhere from 35 to 40 million pistachios a harvest.
It's been really good. A lot of good buyers walk around our booth, lots of contact. It's a big outcome in comparison to some of the shows that we do that are a little bit larger than this. We've had a very solid amount of good buyers.
I think it brings us together as a community. I mean, we have a lot of agriculture in California, and I think it's a brilliant idea to bring them out to California and show them where a lot of their California-grown products are coming from.
It's 50 years old now, and it was started by my dad and myself, because you didn't have the money to buy something. Doesn't mean that you still couldn't do it one way or another. You just had to spend some time thinking about it. Our company has grown and grown. You know, we're over $500 million company now. We're starting from nothing. Being located in the Valley, you know, I think has had a huge impact on our success. You know, as a manufacturer, being close to our raw materials is a competitive advantage. You know, we're close to our meat, our cheese, you know, vegetables. I mean, just on and on. You know, we have about 2,500 employees, and we expect to continue to keep growing. Best location to be is right here in the San Joaquin Valley, the heart, the capital of agriculture.
U.S. Cold is a legacy company. We've been around over 100 years. We started out manufacturing ice, distributing party ice. We've evolved into the refrigerated warehousing business now. So we offer warehouses throughout the country. Basically, heavy concentration in California, supporting the, you know, the local food industry, the agricultural sector, dairy, frozen fruits, produce, food grade dry, refrigerated storage, frozen storage. So that's really what we specialize in. Our Western regional headquarters are right here in Fresno. I'm very impressed with this. This certainly gives the smaller producer a venue to expand his product line. We're good. We're having a good time. I think it's a great venue. I think the show's growing. I think it's going to get larger and larger every year, and we're going to support it.
The company was started by my grandfather in 1922, and he built the Corner Bakery on the corner of M and Santa Clara in downtown Fresno. And so it did start out as just a local corner shop bakery, and then through the generations, it was passed to my uncle and then to my mother and now to myself, so I'm third generation. But we've remained downtown in Fresno. Well, Lavash is a cracker type bread. It is an Armenian cracker bread, and it is basically just an unleavened cracker type bread recipe that we use, and so you can eat it just as you would any other bread. So we have our large traditional round 15 inch and then our 10 inch, which can be broken up and used in a bread basket or as a pizza or an appetizer. But then we also have our really fun small hors d'oeuvre sizes in the shapes of the hearts and the stars and the rounds. And back when it was built, the family home was right next door to the bakery. And so it was really a great Armenian community that was thriving downtown. So there was really no desire to move or to go anywhere else. So we just stayed where we were. And it's really just kind of helped contribute to our heritage and our place in the community.
One at one time was a pretty small company, you know, and my dad started in 1945. As a fresh fruit grower, and then building the business, and then getting into the frozen food business in 1963. We were a very small frozen business, and there were 15 processors across the United States, and we just so happened to be the last of those 15. We're pretty proud to be in probably every major pie manufacturer there is. Our fruit is in it, our peaches are in it. When people think of peaches in particularly, they think of Georgia, not California. And it always makes me laugh because California produces 5 times the amount of what Georgia produces.